Liberal men try to prove they're most manly in America, wrecked by what testosterone results show. Testosterone. Whether liberals want to admit it or not, testosterone is the biological force that makes people want to have babies, and the driving hormone that ensures that the human species will continue. Alpha males possessing large quantities of testosterone is what has kept America safe for generations. Just take a look at what a typical Special Forces soldier looks like, and it's sure not a skinny jeans-wearing wimp holding a non-flat latte kicking down doors, but aggressive and fearless warriors who daily put their lives on the line to take out terrorists trying to destroy our country. You'd think there would be a huge appreciation for the alpha males who keep America safe from terrorists, but lately there seems to be a concerted effort on the part of liberals to demonize males possessing masculine traits. Men with masculine characteristics and aggressive tendencies are constantly demonized by the left, where they're constantly told to sit down and shut up and check their white privilege at the door. Just take a look at constant themes of commercials you see on television, and it's always the American male portrayed as a brainless idiot, while at the same time, the heterosexual-looking, man-purse-carrying wimp is propped up as the standard that American males should try and emulate. As this theme continues to take over our society, there might be a scientific reason that liberal males are the way they are, and it's been right in our genetic code the entire time. Liberal males from BuzzFeed decided to see just how manly they truly were by getting their testosterone levels checked. And what was revealed is not only highly embarrassing for liberals, but provides a scientific proof of what many of us have suspected all along, that liberal males are genetically and physically weak. A panel of liberal writers from BuzzFeed had their levels of testosterone checked as part of a recent investigation into male attractiveness and were completely astonished when their results came in. These girly men were shocked to learn that not only were their testosterone levels drastically lower than average, but their male hormones matched the same testosterone levels that are typically found in 12-year-old boys. Testosterone. Whether liberals want to admit it or not, testosterone is the biological force that makes people want to have babies, and the driving hormone that ensures that the human species will continue. Alpha males possessing large quantities of testosterone is what has kept America safe for generations. Just take a look at what a typical Special Forces soldier looks like, and it's sure not a skinny jeans-wearing wimp holding a non-flat latte kicking down doors, but aggressive and fearless warriors who daily put their lives on the line to take out terrorists trying to destroy our country. You'd think there would be a huge appreciation for the alpha males who keep America safe from terrorists, but lately there seems to be a concerted effort on the part of liberals to demonize males possessing masculine traits. Men with masculine characteristics and aggressive tendencies are constantly demonized by the left, where they're constantly told to sit down and shut up and check their white privilege at the door. Just take a look at constant themes of commercials you see on television, and it's always the American male portrayed as a brainless idiot, while at the same time, the heterosexual-looking, man-purse-carrying wimp is propped up as the standard that American males should try and emulate. As this theme continues to take over our society, there might be a scientific reason that liberal males are the way they are, and it's been right in our genetic code the entire time. Liberal males from BuzzFeed decided to see just how manly they truly were by getting their testosterone levels checked. And what was revealed is not only highly embarrassing for liberals, but provides a scientific proof of what many of us have suspected all along, that liberal males are genetically and physically weak. A panel of liberal writers from BuzzFeed had their levels of testosterone checked as part of a recent investigation into male attractiveness and were completely astonished when their results came in. These girly men were shocked to learn that not only were their testosterone levels drastically lower than average, but their male hormones matched the same testosterone levels that are typically found in 12-year-old boys. InfoWars reported. The average testosterone level for an American male is a range anywhere from 270 to 1,070 nanograms/dL with an average level of 679 nanograms/dL. When a crew from BuzzFeed got their testosterone levels checked as part of an investigation into male attractiveness, 3 out of 4 were apparently low. Eugene, the Asian guy, was the only one of them to have normal testosterone levels, though he was on the low end of the normal range. Studies have shown men who are physically strong are more likely to be right-wing, while weak men are more likely to be left-wing socialists. So now the question becomes, does being a liberal cause your testosterone levels to drop? Or are girly whiny beta males automatically predisposed to be attracted to the liberal Prius-driving lifestyle where they embrace a life of socialism and living off the hard work of others? A recent study conducted in Journal Evolution and Human Behavior produced some very startling results when 171 men were recruited for the study. The Atlantic reported. Are socialists physically weak? For the study, which was recently published in the Journal Evolution and Human Behavior, researchers recruited 171 men and measured their shoulders, chest, and flexed biceps. The men were asked to squeeze a dynamometer to measure their grip strength. The researchers also gauged how much the men valued redistributive economic policies, based on how much they agreed with statements like high incomes should be taxed more than is currently the case. They then measured how much the men had a social dominance orientation, or a preference for hierarchies. Those who thought things like inferior groups should stay in their place rank highly on this scale. When the researchers compared the men's measures of physical strength with their economic values, they found that the less muscle-bound men were both less socially dominant and more likely to support socio-political egalitarianism. In other words, yes, the strong men were less likely to be socialists, if you can call it that. It makes perfect sense when you take into consideration our ancestral past, where males' physical size determined their status and resources, so bigger men would have been fine with a survival of the fittest type system, Michael Price, psychology lecturer at Brunel University London concluded, chalking up this phenomenon to evolutionary theory.